Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this episode of SciShow. If you're looking to start the year by building new habits, there's no better place to channel all that productive energy than with today's sponsor, Brilliant. Check them out at brilliant.org/scishow. Driving can be pretty dangerous. In the US, over 2.5 million people get injured in traffic accidents each year. That's about one person every 12 seconds. And hundreds of thousands of those accidents happen because of a distraction. Like, you could be distracted by stuff going on around you, talking to another passenger, or just changing the car's temperature until something unexpected happens. So to keep our brains on track and our bodies safe, scientists are turning to artificial intelligence to learn how our minds handle distractions and help keep us in a mental sweet spot while we're driving. While you're driving on a busy highway, you might be simultaneously watching out for other cars, turning on the music, and talking to someone in the passenger seat, all while you're trying to maneuver multiple tons of steel going at least 80 kilometers an hour. And juggling all those tasks at the same time is what researchers call cognitive load, or workload. Generally, you'll want to keep your workload from getting too high. Otherwise, you're less likely to be able to respond to a sudden threat by doing things like changing lanes to get out of the way. And scientists are trying to find ways to measure this workload to design and engineer better cars and roads. But this isn't as straightforward as asking drivers directly how they're feeling, because getting an already preoccupied driver to perfectly describe how much mental energy they're using might affect their workload by adding to it. After all, asking someone every couple seconds if they're distracted can be a bit distracting. But a workaround to this problem might be looking out for physical signs that someone's mind is working hard, like increased heart rate, and getting an idea of the size of their workload that way. Like in a study from 2014, researchers had 22 participants in a driving simulator doing an NBAC test. That's when you recall things from your memory based on a sequence of items, like numbers. So for example, someone might say the numbers 3, 7, 5, and participants are then asked to recall which number was read out two steps before, in this case 3, when the number 5 is read. The idea was to use the NBAC test to increase the workload of each driver. While this test was happening, researchers measured participants' heart rates and how much electricity their skin conducted. And scientists found that both the participants' heart rate and skin conductance increased when the task was made harder. And their driving behavior, like how well they stayed in a lane, changed as well, but not as drastically. In another 2014 study, the same researchers flipped the script. They recruited even more participants to drive on real highways while performing the NBAC test on and off at periodic intervals. Then they used the data they collected to train an algorithm to recognize when the participants were doing a task and experiencing a higher workload. The algorithm used heart, skin, and driving data for when the task was being done and when it wasn't, so it could tease out features in the data that helped distinguish between high and low workloads. And it worked. The algorithm was able to determine whether a driver was or wasn't experiencing a high workload with 90% accuracy. But if strapping an electrocardiogram to measure your heart rate while you drive sounds stress-inducing, scientists are exploring other ways of measuring workload too. For instance, scientists could use functional near-infrared spectroscopy, or FNIRS, which shines infrared lights near a person's skin and measures how much light bounces back. The amount of light absorbed by the person's blood can tell scientists the amount of oxygen in the blood. And the whole setup can be made small enough to fit into a headband, which someone could wear so that the scientists could measure the oxygen content of the blood in their brain. If there's a lot of oxygen around, their brain is working hard. Using the data collected by the FNIRS headband, the same researchers developed another algorithm that could also be used to measure the driver's workload in a simulator while they used the NBAC test. And the algorithm worked pretty well in this scenario too, with an accuracy of around 80%. With effective ways of measuring a driver's workload, the hope is that car makers can test out different interfaces in future cars with real drivers to find designs that are simple and safe to use. In fact, new cars could even include indicators for how distracted a driver might be in real time, so that they can change their behavior or slow down to manage their cognitive workload while driving, sort of like a fuel efficiency gauge, but for the mind. All these studies covered when drivers get overwhelmed, but being underwhelmed can be just as bad. Like when you're on a familiar road or when you're simply driving for a really long time, it becomes easier to tune out from what's happening on the road. And as cars are being developed to become smarter and do more of the driving for you, the risks of boredom on the road get higher. Because when we do less and less, it becomes harder for our minds to snap back and take control when we need to. To tackle this, researchers are tinkering with ways to artificially add some workload when drivers are understimulated. For instance, a 2017 study had participants drive in a simulator with and without a kind of smartphone game that encouraged them to stick to changing speed limits. The phone was positioned in a legally allowed holder, and the game was designed to avoid being too showy or distracting. When the game was introduced, the participants drove with less risky behavior, like speeding, and stayed more engaged on the otherwise quiet, boring roads in the simulator. Which is not to say that playing games while driving is something that you should do, but it goes to show boredom can affect how much attention you're paying to what you're doing. So while some machines doing our jobs might make us tune out, there's a hope that soon they'll also be able to help us tune back in. And if you want to learn more about the nitty-gritty of how machines tune us in, you should check out today's sponsor, Brilliant. They are an online learning platform with courses about science, engineering, computer science, and math. With their interactive course algorithm fundamentals, they can help you learn how to program without having to dig through the weeds of coding syntax through these fun interactive challenges. You can shift around blocks of pseudocode, and then you can get immediate feedback on your results. If you'd like to check them out, head over to brilliant.org/scishow or click on the link in the description. The first 200 people will get 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription, and checking them out also helps us, so thanks.